Sox here, and today we're gonna be turning ourselves into aliens from outer space. Take me to your dealer. I'll probe you. If you want to see how I did this look, just keep on watching, and please don't forget to subscribe to my page and click that notification button down below so you know when I come out with my next video. Keep on watching.
All right, so here we go. This is day 16. Yep. Day 16, and we're going to take our liquid latex and our glue. We're going to glue up those eyebrows, get them all waxed up, protect them from the liquid latex that I'm going to put over it in a few minutes. And we're just getting all those edges in, everything, flatten it out, make sure it's dry and everything. Then I'm going to take my Airspun translucent powder. I'm going to dab that powder right on top of the eyebrows to set it right in. You want to get every corner, so make sure you put a lot on there. You want to get everything, tap it all in. Then take a little brush, take off the extra powder off your face. Bam, 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 boom, boom. There we go. All done. We got it. Once I got that all said and done, I'm going to put my liquid latex into my little plate here. I have a little bowl put in there. And I also, before I started doing this, I ripped up tiny little pieces of cotton. And I just had already ripped up pieces of cotton, like in little strips already ripped up, as you can see here. And I'm going to take my, I know you guys know that I hate liquid latex and cotton, but this way was easier for me to do it. I took my Q-tip with the liquid latex. I put liquid latex over my eyebrow. Then I put the cotton on top of the liquid latex I put on top of my skin. Then I took the Q-tip with some liquid latex and I started dabbing liquid latex on top of the cotton. And actually, this worked out way much better than using a sponge. If you see here that I'm dabbing the liquid latex around my skin, that's just to create like a scaly, like skin effect look. And all you see that I'm doing here right now, I am creating like the alien like face. I'm gonna put my scales on the side of my cheek. I put the arched eyebrows. I put like a little design on my forehead. I'm trying to point out the nose and make it like skinny, like, but pointed on the bridge of the nose. I also put some on the sides of my nose because I'm going to make it look a little bit pointier. And like I said, I'm just putting this like a scale, like a gill, like, I don't know, type of thing on the side of my face here. And it was much easier just to use the cotton with the Q-tip, and with the Q-tip right directly on it, since it's already like cotton also. I don't know, it was just easier for me to use the Q-tip with the cotton this time. It went very smoothly, and I really got into molding it. Like, I was molding out the whole face and everything, and it's easier to mold it. So once that gets all dry and you got your face put together, I bought this new grease makeup green from the Halloween store. I think it was $3. Honestly, I hated it. Actually, no. I bought it from Party City for $1.99 and I hated it. First, I started with a brush. Brush wasn't working. Started with a different brush, wasn't working. Then I took my Wet n Wild Fantasy palette. I only had a little bit of green in there. Took the brush, wasn't working. Took a little sponge, and I started digging out the little bit of green I had in that palette. And I just started covering the important parts with that green I did have. So all that white from the cotton and the liquid latex, that's what I'm covering first. Because I didn't have a lot of green in my palette. And I went to Walmart the other day and I bought another palette that I thought it was the same as this palette. And it wasn't. The lighting and me being in a rush and everywhere and a rush in Walmart just totally screwed me up. But I missed it. But I took another Wet n Wild palette with a darker green and I just started putting that all over the green I already had on my face. And I'm just using a whole bunch of different shades of green. Honestly, I use so many shades of green just to cover up the white spots and to make my face look green for you guys. Next, I'm gonna go in. I had some white cream in this tube, like white cream paint in the tube. I'm gonna take that white cream paint and I'm gonna use it as like a highlight color. So I'm gonna highlight my skin with this. So here's the cream makeup in white. I'm gonna put a little bit on the back of my hand and I'm gonna use that same sponge. Well, I'm not putting it on the back of my hand now because I'm a dummy. But I'm gonna highlight my scars so you guys can see the scars because I covered everything in green and you really can't see it. You can see it a little bit, like the texture you can see, but I wanted you guys to see like the scarring on my face. So I'm highlighting the scars, highlighting underneath my eyes. I do the same thing all over the face. Highlight, I use the white to highlight everything. Just scars and everything there. This look took me a while just because like, it wouldn't take me a while, but I was taking my time because I didn't really know what kind of scars to do for my face. But now that I know how to do it, this look will probably take me about 30 minutes to do if I try to do it again another time. But this took me about an hour to do just because I didn't know where I wanted to put the scar and the facing for the alien on my face with all the liquid latex. So that took me a little while and also to mold it the way I wanted and not look gushy because I didn't want it to look like a gushy, nasty skin effect like I usually use the liquid latex and the cotton for. I wanted to like use it to like make the scars of the alien onto my face. So it came out really nice how I wanted it. So, and the white with the highlight, I really like how that came out. Really helped. Define all the colors onto the skin. I'm really just dabbing it on there, and you can see what I'm doing. I take it's on the back of my hand right now, and I'm just swiping the color down, patting it, and I'm putting it right underneath for like a highlight underneath my side of my cheekbone there. Just so I'm trying to like contour my skin. So I'm like a diva alien contouring my skin and whatnot. I just wanted it to look good, you know? Trying all these different things this month. It's really making my creativity like come out of the box. I really like everything how it came out. And I'm just dabbing that color and that green into my forehead and my skin because you can see the color. I didn't, if you want to do this the right way, color your ears. I didn't color my ears because I have this thing about my ears. I put paint in my ears and then it's a bitch to take out of your ears. And then I find green in my I just don't want paint in my ears. I don't I'm a me personally, I don't like paint in my ears. But if you want the full look, paint your ears. It looks good when the ear is painted. So I'm just going in with my Wolf paint. This is face paint. It's like water activated. I love this paint. Taking my black and I'm gonna make just the black eyes circles around the eyes. Now I could have covered out my eyes and blocked them out with a pad and then did all this special effects things and make it look really cool. But at this point it was like 12 o'clock at night or just about to be 12 o'clock at night and this is me taking a shortcut. So I'm just painting the outsides of my eyes black. Just to get the just to get the alien eye effect. I'm also gonna paint my nose and give it like a little point on the bottom of my nose, but you're gonna quickly find out that I effed up this part on my nose. I should have not connected the part. I should have left it like two little triangles. But, you know, when it's late at night and you're doing this stuff, you tend not to think. Especially when you're like in a rush and you're trying to do it fast, like I was, you tend not to think. So watch. I finish up my eye. Here I go. I just wanted to do a little point to my nose. So I did this point, right? And I'm like, ooh, I like how that came out. Then I did this one. And of course, you do one side good and you F up the other side. So you see how it's not even? So I started trying to make it even. It's like putting eyeliner on your eye, like the wing eye, and then you get messed one up and then you try to make the other one look even. That's what I freaking did here with my nose. And then I ended up connecting it, which I should have not have done. Don't make this mistake, you guys. I don't like how my nose came out. It's so ugly. Don't connect it. Just two little triangles will suffice. I try to fix that later on. Try to cover with green, the green paint, and it wouldn't cover because of course it's black and green is not gonna cover up black. Black usually covers up other things. And I effed up and I was like, oh, I'm gonna take it as a loss. Let's take it as a loss. So I'm painting in my other eye. Thank you for hearing me complain about my mistakes on my alien makeup here. But it really was bothering me. It bothered me the whole time. I didn't think it came out right. I didn't know how to take my pictures. I didn't like how it came out. I didn't like how this look came out. Let me be honest with you guys. I hated how this look came out. I could have done so much better with this look, but I'm lazy. And I was tired and it was late. My nose looks so fucked up. I just hate it. And then, as you notice, my eyes weren't even either. So at the end of the video, like I was trying to get them even so I could take the picture and it could look good. But you can see one eye is bigger than the other, one is more ovally. I just messed up so bad. Please don't do this, you guys. Do it the right way. Take your time and do it the right way. Don't be like me. I'm gonna go in with my Morphe Picasso palette and I'm gonna use that black right there. And I'm just gonna use that black and I'm gonna shade out my face and I'm gonna put it on my eye to take that, like, it's not a grease paint, it dries up, but it had like a shiny look to it. So I didn't want that shiny look on my eyes. So I just take that black and I'm gonna highlight my nose lightly. Make it look nice and thin. Highlight my nose. I put it on the sides and everywhere. I highlight the scars between the scars, underneath my scars here. I try like a little contour there with the black, highlighting lightly between the scars so you guys can see the scars. I highlight my eyebrows, the arch of my eyebrows and everywhere, and the middle scarring. And like I said, I take the black and I put it inside my eyes to matte it out a little bit more because it looks a little shiny to me. Well, it still does look shiny. So I just matte it out with the black. Like you would think it looks good, but when you're like me and you're kind of like you like to do this stuff a lot, you see your flaws and it didn't come out right to me. So right now I'm using my Fenty Beauty Wasabi lipstick. Perfect color. Doesn't it match perfectly with my face? And I'm just gonna put it on my lips because of course this grease paint does not cover up the lips that great and it starts to crack. So I was like, let me just get this lipstick. It's the same color. Let me use it and bomb. Look, it just looks so good. Look at that. Look at that. Yeah. Finally put that lipstick to use. Now I'm gonna go in with my black eyeliner and just put it under my water lines of my eyes because I kept on seeing that pinkness of my eyes every time I looked at myself. I was like, let me make this a little bit darker. Even though I'm covering my eyes when I take the pictures and to show you guys, I was like, ugh, let me just cover this up. It's like It was like I hated how the look was coming out so much that I was trying to perfect it at the same time. I didn't know what to do or how it was gonna come out, but I was like, let me do this. Okay. So I finished that. See? I was like, okay, I can't really see it no more. Help me out a little bit. Okay. Now I'm gonna go in with my Jeffree Star Cosmetics Skin Frost, icy frost, skin frost. I don't know. I forgot the name. It's like ice cold skin frost. And this is a highlight of his. And I'm gonna highlight those scars right on my face just to bring them out. Just like I use the white cream to highlight it, this is just gonna highlight it some more and bring the pop out to my face. So I highlight just the scars, nothing else. Oh, I also highlight my lips at the end too, as you'll see. So I just want you guys to see the scars just to make it more look more alien-like. I don't know. You could also use like a metallic. I had like a gray metallic paint with a little bit of glitter in it, but I didn't want to F it up. So I was like, the easiest way to do this right now and the quickest way is to take that highlight. Yes, look at my Alice in Wonderland sniffing coke right there. Yes. So, yeah, just taking the highlight, highlighting those things, and I go ahead and I highlight my lip everywhere here because, you know, I'm a girl alien, so I gotta look bomb. Yes. Ooh, I love how that came out. So pretty. I like the lip look. Everything else was like a disappointment in my thing. You might think it's not, but I think I have failed you in this look. I hate it so much, but I'm gonna post it, 'cause it's my what my day 16 look. Oh, the first time I didn't go in with my eyes, I forgot, so I'm doing it now. Pap 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 pap, making it blacker, making it blacker. See, that eye looks perfect. That's the roundness I wanted. This eye, look, it looks like a fucking avocado. Ugh, it's the shape of an avocado. It's just, ugh. Yeah. I just hate that I always get one side so great and the other side just. I don't know. What is it? I don't know what it is. It happens to me all the time. Never could get the sides looking exactly the same, perfect. And this, I did this, I added this in. Like, you're gonna see that after this video, like, you're gonna see that I don't have this black mark. But at the end of this video, I realized that my face didn't look alien enough. Alienish. It didn't look like an alien. I had to get that skinnier face, and since my face it was fat, I got a fat face. It was just not cutting it. So I took my black paint that I used on my eyes and I just thinned out my face. As you can see, I'm just putting black on the edges here and I'm giving it, you see, it's like more skinnier alien look. And I done effed up because the next video, you're gonna see in my hoodie, I don't have it done like that, but I had to fix it. You just have to fix it like this because it just didn't look skinny enough for me for the alien look. So this is the end of the look. I didn't have the black on the sides at this point here, but this is the end of the look. Sorry, it's not perfect, but this is the end look. Thank you for watching, you guys. Please subscribe to my page. Don't give this one a like. Dislike this one. This was bad work. Very bad work. But thank you for watching. As always, hit that subscribe button. Love you guys.